to animate captions in Premiere Pro, follow these steps. Go to text and then to create transcription. And we've only got one speaker in this vid, so we can keep that no, don't separate speakers. Transcribe and it will render the audio. And then you've got your transcript. So you want to go through that and just check everything, make sure spellings are correct. You can play the vid and it'll go through, or you can do it without playing the vid. So there's a couple of mistakes in here. I'm just going to do these quick. And once that's done, you want to create captions by going to the two C's and then open up preferences. Set the maximum length in characters to whatever you want. I'm going to bring it down to about 16 and I'm going to keep the lines as double. You can set it to single, whatever you want. Create captions. There's our captions on the caption track. Select all and go over to the central graphics and set the caption box to the center. So the captions are now in the center of our image. And if you right click here where it says subtitles and add track, what we're going to do is just create a new track and create a duplicate just to keep it as a reference in case we mess anything up. So if you press Alt and Shift and drag, it'll keep it all in line. And then what we'll do is select this top bunch and go up to graphics and titles and down to upgrade caption to graphic. And there we go. So that's what Adobe couldn't do before. And this gives us all sorts of options now it's on the main timeline. So from here, if we select everything, we go over to essential graphics and change the font. So if we're going Alex Hormozi style, let's go for Montserrat Black. And I think we'll set everything to capitals. Up to the font size. And we'll set it to, let's say 70. Gives us a bit of room. And then we'll move on down to the stroke. And I'll set that to 1.5. Make it black. Then on down to the distance, let's put this to about 4.5. Set this to 12.5 and then the blur to 40. And there we go. If you check out how that looks, we'll try and get a lighter background so you can see it. That's your typical Hormozi caption style. And so from here, we want to add some color. And to do that, I've got a little technique from another YouTuber called Ash Beachy. So shout out to him, this is an amazing bit of time saving. He just creates a little palette for himself and then imports it. And then you've got it, which you can use in the project itself, and you can use the dropper to add color to the captions. If I highlight a word, let's say this one talking, down to the dropper, bottom right, up to whatever color we want, yellow in this case, and it's done. We can make this easier by highlighting the targeting toggle on track 3. Also turn off targeting for track 1. And now you can see as you move the playhead, it selects each clip as you go. So let's go over here and highlight the word yesterday. Go down to the dropper on the right, hit the green, and there we go. So let's assume you've gone through the track, you've added all the colors you want. Now you want to do some resizing. You've got the resize functions available to you that you had in the original captions, the essential graphics. They're now available to you from the main timeline, which is great. So you can resize things and make it look how you want. And then from here, what we can do, which we couldn't do before, is add some effects. So we'll create a little typical Alex Hormozi popping effect here. We hit the scale on the first frame. We'll set that to about 70. Tap the right button along 4 frames and we'll overshoot this a little bit, so we'll go to 110, and then another 4 frames along we'll bring it back to 100. That gives us our little popping effect. So just a little effect, you can create any effect you want, but what we can do from here is save it as a preset. So right click vector motion, down to save as preset, and then we'll call this demo. What we can do from here is select all the clips, go to the preset, type in demo, there it is, we've just created it, that's the popping effect. Drag it to the selected clips on the timeline and it adds it to every selected clip. One more thing we can do is rotate, just move the playhead along, rotate clip by clip, this way, that way, whatever you want to do. Okay, so that's how I do captions, whatever style it is. Hope it helped you with the basics. See ya.